Good morning, today's the day. Got the best shirt out for this one. Been saving this for 3 weeks, I think, or 2.5 weeks to wear this shirt, so it's out. I've only got one. Bacons are cooking, and as I'm doing that, I'm starting to air down. Now, I'm going to talk a bit about these new, well, they're not new, I bought them secondhand, but Nitto tyres compared to my old Mickey Thompson ones. We're airing down now. And I used to screen and really like this feature on the patrols. My STL didn't have that. I can just put the tire deflators on and go. You'll also notice that my car is on start. So at the moment, the fridge is running. Like the center console fridge, the air seats, because they just are there on permanently. The air con's on. Total disrespect for electrical system with this car now. I just leave it running, lights on, whatever. Like, I just cannot flatten the battery, this DCS lithium one. Like, total neglect now. Like, leave the lights on, do whatever, leave the aircon on when you're parked up. Do not care. Just can't flatten the thing. But I was talking about tyres. So I've always run Mickey Thompson tyres. They're really good, great traction. I used to pop sidewalls all the time. But I've gone for Nittos now. And have a look, these Nittos are on 14 PSI, they're only just starting to bag out. Like, usually at sort of an environment like LCMP, I would run probably 20 in the Mickey Thompsons. I'd probably set them at 16 with the aim for them to warm up to 20 for throughout the day. For new players out there, don't get caught by saying, yeah, let's air down to 20. And then you go out on the tracks and you end up at 24, which might be a bit too much for the track. So I'm testing these out. I've gone down to 14. They'll air up to about 17. And I reckon that's going to be my target pressure, which is way lower than I'd normally do. Just means when I'm driving around and turning corners, I can't be a muppet and let the bead roll off. But we're going to see how that goes for traction today. Okay, as for the Friday morning here, let's have a look at some of the cars and the field. Just a little brief look at them. I'll walk you through. Start off with James's car here, which is stock as a rock. He used to have a killer STL back in the day. It has gone up to the Series 4. Start walking our way down here. People are getting up and moving around now. There is a sneaky Ranger that snuck in here as well. Next, we've got Cliffy's Y62 Patrol. This is what I call like the touring setup. 2-inch lift, still, I think 33s are one size bigger, but it goes everywhere with us. Of course, you know, this car, George's car, 35s, lifted, twin locked, blown, kind of burger with a lot. Tom's TIO over here. Rob Oram reckons it's the best car here. That's just because he used to own it. He's a very nice vehicle. Then representing Co-Gear, got Kerry. Are we allowed to show your face on camera? Check out these bush barriers with the wood panelling. Very cool. Then Scott, who I always thought was a Victorian. He's got his TIO here as well. Turns out he's in Queensland. He's bumped in. Hey, what has he got here? You've got something different I haven't seen before. You've got like a bush barrier rear bit.
Made it up yourself.
Yeah, right. How good's that? I need one of them. Come on, bush barrier, make that one of those, please. Then we've got a possibly equally loudest Y62 I've ever heard. This is Gav's paranormal performance beast, only matched in volume by Rob Welsh. Oh, look over here, who have we got over here? This car gets a bit of attention. Oh. No, we'll come back to Brooke. Old mate Wobble here. I like his new plates. Owen. Big lift, core lift. I think he's got an LCA lift as well.
He does. So this is like a 40mm coil lift and a lower control arm lift.
Oh, Andrew's just rocked up. Cars everywhere. This is good. Wobble Wobble.
Hey, man.
Let's have a look around campsite. Here he is. We'll go say hello to Brooke. Coming to say hi. Air it down. What pressure are you going down to?
48.
Yeah, me too, actually. Mm. What are you? Maxis?
Yep, raises, MT.
So I would have always gone down to 20 in the past, but with the Nittos, I find they don't bag out, so I'm doing 14 as well.
Well, these don't bag until about 18 anyway.
Yeah.
It's safe.
Well, they're barely bagging.
Yeah, that's right.
All right. We're just gonna perv on your car a little bit here.
Yeah,
check that snorkel out. Oh, this is another Fabwiz. That's a neat fit. A bit tricky fitting these. I've seen some good and bad ones, but that is a nice fit. Right, who's left here? Okay, can you work out whose car this is? I'll give you a hint. Bit of man salmon on the front with the red lights. He's actually changed his wheels. Luke's car usually runs the red methods. But he's a bit precious, doesn't want to scratch him up. So he's swapped back to his old Nitto 35s. I think that's all the patrols for the moment. Got a sneaky nav that's come in here, brand new, like a month old. Another Ranger. And then all these bloody GQs that rolled in, they're with us, Crusoe. I think they've just come to show us up, to be honest, because these are tough looking rigs too. No doubt you'll see them on the tracks doing what they do best. Where's Crusoe's car? I think he must have gone to the car wash. Anyway, so that's the field as it stands on Friday morning. We'll probably go and line up in a minute and air down and start having a look at some of these tracks. Of course, 3062's here. It's probably already been out on the tracks. The new bush barrier design. The excitement is building. We seem to have like sort of split into two starting groups, early shift and the day shift. We're gonna meet up in a minute, but yeah, we'll sort of about to roll out. Like, this is exciting. So this is Telecom. Totally doable. Matty Webber did it with a camper on last year. Popped some flat. Now we're going to give it a go. or not to, I reckon he will use them. Patrols here now. Who's next? That was the perfect line, I reckon. I haven't done much wheeling in a 62 for quite some time. I must admit, I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm gonna go and give it a go. Oh, here we go. GQ is gonna show us all up now. Kerry says no. Oh, that's a new line. Scared the crap out of me.
tell you, I was freaking out. That's one of the harder tracks I've done. My foot on the accelerator is still on this. I had it in road mode. I've got to press rock. That was crazy. I should have put a camera on the front of the piz next time. Maybe I have to do it again.
Holy moly. And they're not even all here yet. Go.
I don't know what this is called, but there's three tracks. That one's really bad, that one's worse, and that's freaking crazy. So let's see what people go up.
Oh,
I'm over here, so you come up here. just a boulder about halfway up that you can kick out the way for everyone else.
Yeah, you go first on that left one, Ely.
Down the hill.
Doubt that's one of the hardest driven 62s in the country.
It keeps giving air, there's more a couple of bigger steps up here. The lines are real awkward, like you can't straddle them, gonna end up in the rut. Oh, the middle one. Yeah, I'm gonna come up the middle.
Workout for the day.
Well, I do have like 5 people in the car, so
I'm walking over to that middle track. I can already tell it's Gab coming up because you can hear him coming from a mile away. Let's see if I can do this without stacking it this time. Let's see where he is.
You gonna give him another crack, Gab? I think you get over it, just a little bit more management.
Yeah, and then come up now. And then just no backing up for me. Power.
Someone to drop a rock in that hole, Gav.
George has taken the left. George has got a bit of a handicap of weight. This thing weighs over 4 ton. It's got all the parts. Let's see how it goes up here.
Thank you.
really is amazing what the capability of these cars are.
Ooh, Brooksy's got his bonnet up. Oh, let's go see what's going on down there. It's bleeding. What's the status,
Brooksy?
Oil
catches a light. Steering rack, I think.
Oh, no.
Pissing out oil everywhere underneath.
No, no. The second 62, third 62 that's done a rack in the last couple of months, I don't know about. I hope Nissan got good stock. Right, that was the morning session. Groups got split up. That little run that you saw everyone going up and ended up busting that power steering rack, it split the group up. We had, I don't know, half a dozen cars or so go up there, and that went from like silly crazy extreme to like another three levels above that. We're listening to them on the radio and it's get the winch out, right hand down a little bit, and there were obviously they had some events going on there, so we separated our groups and come back to camp. Oh, other groups. I'm gonna call them the extreme group. They're coming back as just now, leaving Ilya with his, you know, there's not much more that you can do to a car that what he's got. He had to winch twice, I'm told. So we'll stop, reset, and then probably go out again this afternoon. Okay, this is the bucket list point of the video. This is Camp Road. We're all going down there. We're gonna spend the whole afternoon there, basically. First year, it was treacherous. Second year, it wasn't too bad at all.
You're in the front seat, Levi.
Third year, who knows? We're gonna go and have a look, but
looking good, Gavin.
The excitement level went
like that. Just, you're not here. You're a brand new one.
Let's go.
Never seen a Y62 traffic jam to get to Camp Road. Look at this. It's just Y62 everywhere.
Love the bush barriers. Patrol after patrol after patrol after patrol. Tell me this ain't living.
Love you too, Sina.
Over the last hour, we just got a shut back gate.
Yeah, copy that point.
Here we go, we're at the bottom. Well, George is straight into it. This is what it looks like at the moment this year. Start is pretty sketchy actually.
Better put in low range.
George reckons he needs to put on low range. Anyway, here we go. I'm gonna go walk up and have a look. Pipped him at the post. see what it looks like this year, eh? George, you want to have a look first, I reckon. Walk it. You might, well, it's a kind of one that some years you need a spotter.
Ilya's up there. I trust Ilya.
I don't know if I trust you.
I can send it.
Oh, yeah, Ilya is up there. We've got some spotters. He'll be alright. He just wants to be first. Alright, for 2021, George has popped Camp Road Cherry. It's done. Now let's send them all up. Every time I've filmed Camp Road, I've always done it from the other side because that's where you see the wheel lifts. But this side, left-hand side, you see how close it gets to the embankment up here because it's like this. So I've swapped sides. Next car comes up, I'll show you what I mean. Thank you.
That's exactly where we want it to be, you know? That's what happens with the bypass.
Then, mate.
Levi, did you get all that?
Thank you.
think so, did it?
Kerry has decided to bring his beast up. It's pretty much stock as a rock. I'm gonna feel real bad if he does it better than me, which wouldn't be that hard because I think I was stuffed up royally. But let's chase Kerry up and see how he goes. Don't do what Dave did. Kiss. Lost the tyre. Halt. Yeah, no, you've lost the tyre.
I think it just bled out a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, alright. He did that well. That's day one, two, I don't, whatever. cracker day. So good. Like really, really so good to catch up with everyone, meet these people, be in this amazing campground. There's so many cars. I've lost count. I don't know how many, maybe 30 cars. I've been walking up here. So my camp's down the other way. The rainwater tank just up there, I can get one bar of service, and it's just enough. Occasionally I can get analytics to see what the video is doing. I get all the messages. I don't know what's going on with this DCS stuff. Like, I've been out of service, but I've got a few messages and I'm looking at them, and to be honest, they don't make sense, but I feel like I've been, I don't know what's going on, but I'm doing what I do best, and I beat to my own drum, so I'm just going to keep doing that. And
If you've got through this long a video, I'm dead impressed that you're still here. I'm about to sign off, but look at this. There's a bar being set up. I should go to the other side, actually. I'll go to the other side. It's Christy's 40th birthday. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say the number, but tonight we've got a guy in doing cocktails, margaritas. What are they called? I don't drink coffee. The coffee martini things. And yeah, it's all getting set up now. There's a smoker, which I'm quite interested in. Been gagging to do like a brisket or something. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to squeeze that in. We'll see how we go. But this is like end of day one. Heaps of other shenanigans happened, but like you'd be watching this video for 3 hours. So I've just tried to put in the good bits. More tomorrow. There's more people coming tomorrow. They're going to end up like filling all of this area out there. So signing off. Whoa. So good. So good. Very happy. I'll see you tomorrow on YouTube. Yeah, yeah.